You're listening to the Street Smart Wealth Experience, show number 355. Today we're going to talk about getting very clear and writing down the systems and the consistency and the accountability that you're going to put into your business to ensure your success. Well, hello, hello, and welcome to today's show. This is one of my favorite topics, getting systems in place in your business and then staying consistent with those systems and then having the accountability. And I got to tell you, I totally understand it. I understand resistance more than anything. As I shared on the last show, I recorded this show and the previous one back in January, but it's February when I'm processing it and dealing with all of the moving parts that go into it, and a lot of it comes down to resistance. There's only so many hours in the day, and as you know, as a solopreneur, yes, you outsource some stuff, but sometimes the process of getting that set up and outsourced is challenging too, and that's just an excuse, and I get it, but I'm owning it, like hopefully you own your excuses too. So I totally understand resistance. Back in 2018, my focus word was systems. I knew that it was important for me to systemize my business, and we'll talk about that in the show. Hey, listen, I would love it if you're gaining any value if you would give me a review over at iTunes. You can just go to jackiealmer.com/iTunes, and it'll take you right into my podcast over there. And once you do that, if you'll send me a screenshot along with your physical mailing address, I have some success affirmations put together that I'm going to actually mail to you so that you can really work on your mindset. You can email that screenshot and your mailing address to jackie@streetsmartwealth.com. I wanted to quickly share a testimonial with you from Cindy, one of my newer coaching clients in the Street Smart Wealth Academy. And what she said is, I am feeling more confident and have been closing more than I did at this point last year. I'm understanding better how to present and how to let them know that I'm the expert in this area. And I know what plan they need by listening more to what they do. And I can honestly see myself making improvements and being more motivated and confident in my business. And I am so thankful. And she said, I closed both potential clients today, and that was a great feeling. So if you're looking for those type of results in your business, let's set up a call and talk about it. You can go to streetsmartwealthacademy.com and fill out the form, and let's have that conversation. All right, let's get into today's show, where we're going to talk about systems, consistency, and accountability. You'll find the show notes at 355.streetsmartwealth.me. All right, so let's talk specifically about systems, okay, consistency, and accountability. So starting with systems are those things that really will create a breakthrough for you in your business. And they create a breakthrough in a lot of different ways they'll create a breakthrough for you. First and foremost, they give you a roadmap to follow. And that's so very important. It's so important to have a roadmap to follow, to know every step of the way, wherever you are in the process of working with people and building your business, that you know exactly what the next step is. And this helps create that confidence that you need to actually take that next step. And that's very, very important. Now, when you think about big companies that have had success, one for me that always comes to mind is McDonald's. And the biggest reason that comes to mind for me is I actually worked at McDonald's as a teenager. And the one thing that we were taught very early on as we went through the whole training program were the systems that were in place. Whether you were working in the back and actually cooking, ugh, I hated that part. I don't even eat beef, and I hated the whole burger cooking part of it. But nonetheless, there were systems. You put the patties on the grill, you flipped them at a specific time when the timer went off, you put the onions on at a specific time,
And then you set up the bun. Everything was done on systems. The French fry machine, you put it in, set the timer. When the timer went off, you pulled it up out of the fryer and it drained, and you knew exactly what to do. So systems make your business run. Now, an interesting story, just back to my days working at McDonald's as a teenager, on Saturday afternoons in the summertime, the management would run contests to see who could make the most sales during that period. Now, of course, we were taught how to upsell a milkshake, how to upsell hot apple pies, and the menu's probably changed so much I can't even imagine. I don't remember the last time I walked into a McDonald's. But I figured out how to create my own systems as a 17-year-old working at McDonald's, and I won that contest almost every single Saturday. And I usually walked out of there with 20, 25, 30 bucks in my pocket cash on top of what I made. And back in the 70s, 80s, that was a lot of money. That was more than enough money to go to the movies and buy flicks and, all kinds of fun stuff and all that great thing. So the way I figured it out is I would take somebody's order and I would print off the receipt, I would put it on a tray, and then I would start working on that order. And in the summertime, it got so busy that sometimes we would be out of Big Macs. I don't even remember what all was on the menu, but we would be out of that, or French fries would be cooking. I would get as much ready on the tray, I would slide it down, I would ask them to step over, and I would help the next person that stepped up. So I had a system, whereas everybody else would take one order, they would start it, and then they would hang around waiting for the rest of the products, the food products, to become available to finish that order and put it out there. And we were so busy and everything, nobody paid any attention to what I was doing. And then ultimately, in that particular store in Durango, Colorado, they began to teach my system for doing that. But I figured out early on how to build systems. And once I became a network marketer and involved in direct sales, as you know, that's my biggest claim to fame, was building a multi-million dollar business in network marketing, and now coaching and training on a number of topics, but most specifically the business skills, everything from online to offline marketing, mindset, and of course, those systems and consistency and accountability that help you be successful. So, in terms of those type systems in your business, you'll have to think about what that is. But for me, there's three primary components to my business. The first one, of course, is the programs and the products and services that I offer. For the most part, my coaching programs, my training, that's what I focus on. So my systems around that are in place. I know what happens when somebody new comes in as a client, how to onboard them, how to start them in the training, how to hold them accountable, how to work them through the system so that if they do the work, I've already done my part to ensure their success if they'll show up and meet me and do their work too. So my systems are already in place in terms of my programs, my offers, and what I'm actually selling to monetize in my business. So that's a piece of homework for you. What are you actually selling? Okay, watch the last live that we did, listen to the last podcast so that you know exactly how to get that clarity around what it is that you're actually selling, and then you'll build those systems around that particular thing. Okay, so that's step number one. What are you selling? What's your offer? How do you monetize it? Build the system around that. Now, then for me, the second step, then of course, is marketing. And that's everything. That's lead gen. Okay, that is my online and offline social media, Facebook Lives, my YouTube channel, my podcast, my live networking. I'm a very active member of BNI, Business Network International. I just got off the call with a lady today doing a one-to-one who's in network marketing and direct sales, who has closed over $400,000 in her network marketing business in the last, I can't remember if it was 5 or 6 years, as a member of BNI. If you have questions about that, leave them below or contact me because I would love to have a call with you. Or better yet, book that call that I talked about. Go to call.streetsmartwealth.me, book that call. Let's talk about those systems and that particular system. Okay, so that's what my marketing system consists of. So I know the systems that are in place. Every week, I know what I'm doing with Facebook Live, my blog, my podcast, my YouTube channel, any passive marketing that I'm doing. I also know what I'm doing with passive slash active marketing in terms of being out in front of people. That's my number one goal with marketing, is to meet people and build my funnel. Meet people, introduce myself, introduce my business, my products, and my offers to them, ask them to join, ask them for referrals, and put them into my follow-up funnel, which is the third component of my business, of course, which is follow-up. So you want to make sure that you have all three of those systemized in your business, okay? That's how you create business for success that allow you to know what you're doing every step of the way, every minute of the day. Don't mean to rhyme there, but it's kind of fun. You know what you're doing in your business and what it is that's going to move you forward. So that is systems. Create those systems for success. All right. The next one that I mentioned is consistency. Consistency is a key part of it. And I think at the end of the day, it is everything. It's not how great your product or service is. It's not how great your Facebook Lives are. It's not how great or eloquently you can deliver what it is that you're doing. It's truly how consistent you are at showing up day in and day out, providing value, not just doing a sales pitch, providing value and building that marketing funnel, meeting people, making sure that they go into your marketing funnel. Okay, a marketing funnel is not just online. That's a big key part of it. And if you're not creating one, join me over in the Street Smart Wealth Academy and let's get you trained and educated on building that entire online marketing funnel so that you can even take your marketing efforts and that lead gen that you're doing offline and add them to your funnel so that it's working for you. Your online funnel is working for you over and over and over again. This is important because you can't be there every day in front of your audience. You can't constantly really be putting yourself out there in front of people offline. So when you add that online component to it, then you are going to catch them every which way that you can and ultimately capture them when the time is right for them in their business. Okay, so make sure that you have consistency in what you're doing. A big part of consistency is getting it on your calendar. Now, I meant to grab my day planner, but I forgot it, and I don't want to get up because we're right in the middle of this. But my day timer, it's a huge part. Everything goes in there. My family knows. I laugh because I'm a big proponent of the Enneagram, and I'm a 3 on the Enneagram, if you are familiar with that at all. If not, leave me a comment, and I will share some tools with you to really not just take the online test, because those aren't always effective. It takes a little while for a lot of people to figure theirs out. But one of the things that I'm guilty of is I put everything on my to-do list, including people. It's kind of a joke. It's not that you're on my to-do list as my spouse or my children because I don't remember you. It's just that I have to make sure that I remember you at the right time. My daughter and I have a joke about it. I used to have a calendar reminder that reminded me 30 minutes before I was supposed to go pick her up at tennis. It's not because I forgot that I was going to have to pick her up at tennis, but without that reminder, I might get super busy and be late. And I didn't ever want to do that. So I put everything on the calendar. Everything that I do goes on my calendar. Okay. And I'm one of those that's guilty even after it's happened sometimes. I'll go in and put it on the calendar, but that helps me daily, weekly, monthly, and annually look back. Because when I get to accountability here in a minute, you're going to know what I'm talking about. It helps me look back and say, how did I do with consistency? And what type of accountability do I need? So everything goes in my calendar. A good example today, I call it Marketing Mondays. I block my Mondays off. I don't do a ton of coaching calls. I'll do a few, but Monday is marketing day for me. So it's when I go through my calendar, I create content. I create those things that need to be done in my business. And it's just easy for me. Mondays, a lot of times people are busy doing the same thing, catching up from the weekend. So for me, it's not always the best day to make calls, but it's a great day to kind of do my passive marketing. I will do follow-up calls later in the day, but in the morning, that's mostly all blocked for my marketing content and creating all that. And again, a huge part of that consistency is making sure that every day, in some way, I am meeting new people and adding them to my funnel, either my offline funnel or my online funnel. They're going into the system. I did a BNI one-to-one today with a BNI member in Little Rock, Arkansas, and it was fantastic, and I immediately got all of her contact information. I got her address. I got her details. after the call. And of course, she went into my offline marketing funnel as well as my online marketing funnel. So boom, that's already going to start. And I know that not only through the mail is she going to get follow-up so that she's hearing from me regularly and I'm staying top of mind that way, but also through my online efforts, she's going to stay top of mind with me too. So she may become a client, she may never become a client, but if she gets really sold on me and I work to build that know, like, and trust in the relationship, the number of referrals that she could send to me is staggering. So make sure that you've got consistency in meeting people and working your calendar, which leads me to the third and final piece, which is accountability. Accountability is a big part of it, and you can be your own best self-coach if you'll get very specific with all three of these areas, including accountability. Here's something that I was taught early on. You can't measure what you don't track. And the only way to really know if we are being successful, if we're growing, if we're improving our sales ratios, if we're improving the number of people we need to show our business to, the number of people we need to get in front of, before we actually get that sign up or make that sale, the only way we can really track that is if we are measuring it, if we are recording it, so we can go back and look. So that's a great thing for you to do with your accountability. And that's why I mentioned I write everything in the calendar. Even if I go back and put it in the calendar a day later or a week later, including my content creation. So today, blocked in my calendar, is the time frame for doing my marketing. And then under that, I went back in and I'm going back in and writing down exactly what it was that I did. So I can see, oh my gosh, it's a beautiful Monday in Scottsdale, Arizona with a 70 degree day. And yes, I did spend part of my day sitting out in the sun, having lunch and writing out some of my marketing plan. But that way I know that I didn't just waste the whole day doing just that. Unless that was on my calendar, which it actually wasn't, but I was multitasking, if you will, and enjoying some of this beautiful weather while I still continued to work on my marketing calendar and my content. So again, you can't track what you don't measure. So if you're not measuring it, if you're not writing things down, how can you track it? When you look back at the end of the day, when you look back at the end of the week, when you look back at the end of the month, and honestly, when you look back over the end of the year, if you'll go back in and catch my training on closing out 2019 and preparing for 2020, you'll see that I took you through exactly, I closed out the decade too. I had all decade, I had all 10 of my planners for the whole last decade. And every year I go through that and I look at that and I measure my business, I measure my results, I see what worked. And I always like to start with what worked because it's positive. And then I go through and I look at what really didn't work. Where was I spending a lot of time but wasn't truly getting that ROI, that return on investment that was going to pay off for me? So accountability is a huge, huge, huge part of it. And I recommend if you need to get an accountability partner. Now, I joined a coaching program, gosh, it'll be 2 years. 2 years ago in May, I joined a coaching program, and it was a very small group of women here in the Phoenix, Scottsdale area. And at the end of it, three of us had really, really bonded. When the year was over and that ended, three of us had really, really bonded. Three totally different businesses, all women, and we really bonded. And so we decided to keep it going, and we set up our own mastermind and accountability group. And I have to tell you, in fact, I sent them a text this weekend and said, you guys have been a lifesaver for me, because just knowing, so every Monday morning, we do a call. We do a Zoom call. We get together. We share how our previous week was, what worked, what didn't work, what we're working on. So we talk about the last week and you know, where we did well, where we stumbled. And then we set our goals and intentions for the next week. We have a Facebook group where we shoot videos and weigh in and ask for advice and stuff during the week. But then we get on live every Monday and we go through it. And that has seriously been the best accountability ever, because I was in a bit of a struggle spiral mode when I was in this coaching program, really trying to put together the core components of my business, the core and the key components of my business. What did I have? Because I have all these skill sets now. I'm not bragging, I just do, because I've done so many different things over the last 26 years as an entrepreneur. And yes, the 21st was my year, my 26th year anniversary as a work-at-home mom and entrepreneur. So I've developed all these different skill sets, and I'm passionate about most of them. So it was really trying to figure out how to pull all that together in my business to make it a success. And having this accountability, having these partners, having these women that I had to show up for every week and state what I had done, state what had worked, hoping that there would be something that worked, and there always is, and what didn't work, and set my goals and intentions for the next week. And I don't know about you, but I'm very competitive in that way, and I'm not going to show up week after week, oh, well, you know, I didn't get anything done, or I said I was going to do this, but real life got in the way, or whatever. I was very, very specific, and still am, and show up every week with something done. Does that mean that real life doesn't get in the way sometimes? Of course not. Of course real life gets in the way. It happens for all of us. But knowing that I have to show up makes me show up with my best effort forward. So that's my final thoughts on accountability. You know, what I hear from entrepreneurs regularly is that selling is hard, finding people, the right people is hard, real success on social media is hard, handling objections, that's really hard. How do I answer it when they say I can't afford it, or that sounds confusing, or I don't have the time, or whatever? Just in general, I hear that success is hard. And the reality of it is, it doesn't have to be hard. It doesn't have to be a struggle. And I mentor network marketers and solopreneurs on how to take the struggle out of success and how to put the success back in your business so that you learn those skills that pay the bills. Because I know that when you know what to do and when to do it, and you have all these tools and pieces in place, that you're going to get into action, and that action is going to produce for you. So if you're looking for assistance with your mindset, your beliefs, those limiting beliefs, that negative chatter, that negative voice that sits on your shoulder that says, oh my gosh, you know, why do you think that you can do this? You're not good enough. You're not smart enough. You tried this before and it didn't work. Whatever those roadblocks are that are keeping you stuck, we get rid of those. If you've struggled with who's your target audience? Who's that ideal client that you're speaking to? And how do you develop that success language that gets them to lean in and say, wow, that sounds interesting. Tell me more. Or wow, I might be interested in that. When do you have time to share that with me? Or whatever it is, when you know how to position yourself in that way and answer and identify their challenges better than they can, and then offer those solutions, then you know that you have a recipe for success and you're going to do extremely well with your business. If you struggle at all with developing that ongoing marketing plan, do you wake up every day and know what you're going to do to market your business? Do you have that core component, that second piece that we talked about in the systems, that marketing piece of it? Do you have that written out? Do you know offline what you're doing every day, every week? Do you know online what you're doing every day, every week, so that it's effortless and really and truly creates that lifestyle business for you? Because once you have that developed, you can use it over and over and over again, swapping out a few key things, but for the most part, you can do that over and over and over again. And then finally, you want to make sure that you know how to engage yourself in authentic sales. There's a very specific 5-step process that you can take people through that guarantees a sale or a referral or at least interest, so that you can get them into your follow-up funnel and over time sell to a big number of those people when you understand and you execute that authentic selling process. And I would love to teach that to you. And then if you struggle at all with time management, productivity, then we cover that too. If we haven't had a phone conversation, or even if we haven't, it's been a while and you're interested in considering coaching, go to streetsmartwealthacademy.com. There's a form there that you can fill out. Let's get on a strategy session and let's talk about where you are, where you want to be, and where you feel like you're struggling. And I would love to share some ideas and concepts with you to get you unstuck. All right, so where are you struggling? Let me know, book that call, and let's get you very clear on every aspect of your business and creating the success that you truly want.
Like I said before, the struggle is real and I totally get it. But once you really do get your systems outlined and sit down and take that time, and then you plot it into your calendar so that you stay consistent and you track that and you get your own accountability, you're going to love your business and you're going to rock it out. I'll see you on the next show. If you would like even more tips and training, I have a free gift for you over at streetsmartwealth.me. It's my guide, Unleash the Power of Social Selling. If you're ready to stop struggling in your business and develop a sales and social media strategy to attract your ideal clients, team partners, and create the success you dream about, grab the guide right now over at streetsmartwealth.me. You'll find more on my blog at streetsmartwealth.com, as well as my Facebook group, streetsmartwealthschool.com, and follow me on Instagram at Jackie Elmer. And make sure you learn more about the Street Smart Wealth Academy over at streetsmartwealthacademy.com. I'll see you on the next show.